The Speaker of Parliament, Annette Anita Among, on Wednesday was forced to postpone the consideration of the National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024 after the plenary sitting turned chaotic following the presentation of the majority report from the Agriculture Committee recommending the abolishing of Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, and provide for a transitional period of 3 years. In an unusual move, the bill attracted three reports, including the majority report and two minority reports from MPs in the opposition, who opposed the merger, saying it would be detrimental to Uganda's coffee sector.
Once our competitors realize that we have abolished the agency that was taking over this role, they will rejoice because they will definitely take over the market.
That it is not the privilege of government executive to take away everything they establish as they desire. When you create entities, they are not for you, they are for the nationals.
Statistics in our constituencies show that because of coffee and UCDA giving them seedlings, people have got money.
Maybe you could tell us how much UCDA is consuming from your treasury. We would mobilize cooperatives and associations, coffee associations in this country, to foot that bill, since you do not want to finance them.
During yesterday's plenary sitting, the Speaker temporarily halted the proceedings after the Leader of Opposition, LOP, Mr. Joel Senyunyi, charged legislators to oppose the decision to head into the mid and final stages of processing the National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024.
Honourable members, the ones who voted nay, be on this side. Those who voted aye are on this side. Give me the numbers. Give me the numbers.
Under Rule 101B, where the Speaker has announced the results of the voice voting, and immediately 40 or more members stand in their places signifying their disapproval of the outcome of the vote. Yes. Right, Honourable Speaker, these are over 40 members, yes, and they are standing, yes, in disapproval of the vote that you have announced. These members are standing not because of indiscipline, they are standing in pursuit of our rules.
Eventually, Speaker Among yielded and subjected the report of the Committee on the National Coffee Bill to a head count in accordance with Rule 101 of Rules of Procedure, ordering all members to vacate the plenary chambers for head counting. Results revealed that 77 voted against nays the second reading, while 159 members had voted in support. The bill seeks to merge the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, with the Ministry of Agriculture as part of the government's rationalization of agencies and public expenditure, RAPEX policy.
To vote, we went for voting because we did not believe in the results. I now want to announce the results. The nays had 77. Congratulations. The ayes had 159. So the ayes and abstainers are nil, so the ayes have it, and I adjourn the House of Dime.
In a bid to protect Lake Victoria's fragile ecosystem, communities around Luzira Portbell have launched a collective effort to mitigate pollution and preserve the lake's natural resources. The groups have agreed to do regular community-led cleanups to remove plastic waste and debris from the lake shores, establish designated waste collection points and recycling programs, as well as running sensitization campaigns. Speaking at the community cleaning Bulunji Buansi exercise at Portbell Market on Wednesday, the Nakawa Division Mayor Paul Mugambe sounded an alarm calling the public to stop dumping waste in the lake. Plastic waste chokes Lake Victoria's waters and shores, harming aquatic life and contaminating the food chain. Carelessly discarded plastic bags, bottles and microbeads find their way into the lake.